Hey folks, Matt from RightOfTheImage.com, hot on the heels of just discussing the new 70 Mark III specs that Canon Rumors was reporting. I'm really excited about the fact that we're looking at 4K and a 30 megapixel sensor, which is something I've been calling for in a crop sensor for a while. If you look back at my 90D wishlist, my 73 wishlist videos a while back, that's what I was hoping we would see. So kudos to Canon if this is actually what's coming down the pipe. There are a couple of issues, as Canon Rumor says. Some of the readers were pointing out some issues with this spec list. And so I want to discuss it with you guys and see what you think. Some of them are some pretty valid points. The first one I don't really think is a valid point, but I want to know what you guys think. 30 megapixels at 12 frames per second would be much greater throughput than both the EOS 1DX Mark II and the EOS 5D Mark IV currently have. Can dual DIGIC 7 processors handle this? So while it's kind of a good question, I don't think it's really a concern, because if they can't, then we'll see DIGIC 8s. Then maybe that will be the first camera that introduces the DIGIC 8 processors. Basically what I'm saying here is technology will solve the problem. And 30 megapixels at 12 frames per second, I suspect that the dual DIGIC 7 can handle that. And if they can't, again, we're probably not going to see this camera now until the first half of 2018. They've been working, they're always working on this R&D-wise in the background. So it may be the introduction of dual DIGIC 8 processors. And great, because that'll just pave the way for the 1DX Mark III, for the EOS 5D Mark V, and we'll just see basically the latest technology in the 7D Mark III. So, which will make 7D Mark III shooters happy. So, I don't think it's a problem. What do you think? Let me know in the comments below. If you disagree with me, let me know why. No AA filter on a camera very targeted at birders could be problematic. Be interested in hearing what bird photographers think about this. Well, I too would be interested in hearing what bird shooters think about this. However, I'll go back to my points on the earlier video. The D800 and the D800E were amalgamated into the D810 because Nikon quickly realized they didn't need to give people the option, because there was no real problem with moiré when they removed or put in a weaker AA filter. And we've seen this with a lot of the Nikon cameras. We've seen this with a lot of other cameras, even in the Panasonic lineup and in other companies. And I think what we're seeing is this is not an issue. The rumor is that the new 5DS Mark II, or 5DS R Mark II, I guess it's going to be called, because they're going to amalgamate those two. Canon's going to do it there. Again, they've seen the same thing that Nikon saw, that there wasn't an issue when they removed the A filter or put in a weaker one. And the other thing they could do is they could use, which has been done on I think more than one camera now, is put in an electronic AA filter. So if you're in a shooting situation where the situation is causing a moiré problem, you turn on the electronic AA filter. Or you could even have it a drop-down AA filter. I think there's a lot of tech solutions for that. But in general, I don't think the AA filter is going to be an issue, even for a camera targeted at birders. But what do you guys think? Especially if you are somebody that shoots a lot of wildlife and birds, let me know in the comments below. Do you think this is going to be an issue? Is it a concern for you? Or do you think, as I've been saying, that it's basically already been solved, which is why we're seeing companies moving away from it? Let me know in the comments below. SD fast and C fast. That would mean having to carry three memory card types if this camera is used to back up the EOS 1D X Mark II, which is quite common with the EOS 7D Mark II. Which is true. I mentioned that before. A lot of people carry a 7D in combination with one of their full frame bodies so that they can get the best of both worlds. You get the extended reach when you throw on a lens because you get the crop factor. So, and that is an issue I raised as well. For personally, I don't like the CFast cards. I think the SD cards are fast enough now. They're great cards. We just had that new A-Data card released, which I think is maybe the best-selling card. I just read an article on it. I don't have it up right here, but there's a brand new A-Data card with 290 megabytes a second, I believe, was the read speed. And I think that's the UHS U3 version 2, if memory serves, with the nomenclature. And they had those, I mean, it's an ultra super fast card at a very good price. I'll put a link below. I'll find the A-Data link for you and put that below. So this is what I would like to see. I would like to see two SD cards. I don't think there's any need for this CFast slot. But what do you guys think? Do you think that the CFast should be on there? Do you want to see that on a 7D Mark III? Let me know in the comments below. Let's discuss it. Again, I think it should be two SDs. If you don't, let me know, but let me know why. Let's flush it out there. And then another comment was, we think 30 megapixels is way too high for an APS-C sensor unless Canon has made great strides in lowering noise. No. I guess I shouldn't say no. It's a concern people are raising. For me, no, I don't think it is a problem. I think the 24s have been out for long enough now, for several years. I mean, we've had the 24 megapixel sensor in the A6300 Sony, in the Nikon D7100. We've had it in the 80D. It's been out for long enough now that the tech has evolved, because tech is evolving at such a fast pace now. I don't think there's any problem when you look at the sensors we're getting in full frame, getting a 30 megapixel APS-C sensor that is performing at least as good as our 24 megapixel APS-C sensors in the cameras that I just mentioned. The other thing is, as I mentioned in the previous video, if that is a concern, well, give us the 30 megapixel sensor so that for those of us that are shooting something where we want the resolution, maybe landscape or some type of commercial photography or whatnot, if just the lighting's adequate, then you can shoot at low ISO and it doesn't matter and you get the full juicy 30 megapixels. But give us also SRAW and MRAW and, you know, pixel bin it, down res it, however you want to play with the behind the scenes wizardry to make that smaller file size that will in turn give us a much better high ISO and perhaps better dynamic range file. In which case you get the best of both worlds. That's the optimum solution here that I see. What do you guys think? Let me know in the comments below. Curious to hear your feedback on that one. And the last point, there was, I guess, five of them here that they had brought up, was we think a crop for 4K recording on an APS-C sensor would drive videographers crazy. Yeah, a crop on an APS-C sensor is going to drive some people crazy. There are some cameras out there that do some pretty severe cropping when they're shooting 4K. On the other hand, it's better than not having 4K. Canon has a very nice 10-18 DX lens at a very economical price. I think I bought mine for under $200 new or refurbed. Even if you're getting that crop on there, you're still able to get a fairly wide angle on it and shoot in 4K. And then the other thing is it opens the door for some manufacturers to come in with something even wider. I mean, my favorite wide, the Canon 10-18 I really like, but my favorite with money not being an issue for APS-C is the Sigma 8-16, because the Sigma 8-16 gives you the 8, and 2 millimeters is a lot in the wide end, and I think it's a better built lens, and it's a nicer lens, it just costs a little more. 10-18 is a great value from Canon. The Sigma 8-16 is a better lens, just costs a little more, and gives you that extra width, which now if we're talking about a crop on 4K, you probably will pay to get that if you're doing a lot of video. And there'll probably be more options coming along, like 6 millimeter. So I think that's fixable, workable, doable, and I'd still rather have 4K than not have 4K. But what do you guys think? Let me know in the comments below. Is that going to be an issue for you? Do you think it's going to be an issue to solve it? Is there another solution to solving it that I hadn't thought of? Let me know in the comments below. These are the concerns that were raised from readers on Canon Rumors, the five main concerns regarding the new specs we've been talking about on the 7D Mark III, and I want to know what you guys have to say about them. Let me know in the comments below. Let's discuss it. Thanks for tuning in, folks. Stay tuned. We'll be back soon here at artoftheimage.com.